So let's play this video then. Kundal, you're on mute. Right. All right. I hope you enjoyed the short video. Good afternoon and welcome to another webinar with the Destination Knowledge Center. And my name is Kuntil Barwa. And today's webinar is Kathakali, God's Own Story. We will be in conversation with Sarath Kumar, a Kathakali maestro based in Kochi. This is from our Music and Dance of India series. A lot of you wanted webinars on music and dance forms of India. So this is our first webinar from the Music and Dance of India series. Welcome, Sharad. Thank you so much for being with us today. It's good to see you after many, many, many years. I remember that afternoon in your studio where you taught me a few moves and also shared with me, I never knew about it, but all the health benefits of the different mudras of the Kathakali, which we are going to talk today. It was a wonderful session. I still remember. I'm going to turn off my video because I want to save some bandwidth, but I'll continue talking with you. Just let me turn off my video because I'm sitting here in a remote location. So I want to save some bandwidth. Okay. So let me introduce Sarath to you guys. Our guest is Sarath Ray. He's a Kathakali maestro who is based in Cochin. Sarath started learning Bharatanatyam at the tender age of 5. His journey with Kathakali began soon after, under the tutelage of Sri Kalamandalam E. Vasudevan Nair at the age of 12. After successfully completing his training in 1997, he became a disciple of Padmashri Kalamandalam Krishnan Nair. Sharath has had fortune of working with several great maestros during his career. He has participated in various competitions and festivals that earned him prizes and awards. He was selected to represent India in the World Youth Festival held in Havana, Cuba, as the young, and he was the youngest cultural ambassador of India to go on that particular festival. Inspired by his career as a professional Kathakali artist, his father established the Cochin Cultural Center, where Sharath currently acts as the director. Welcome, Sharath. Welcome, Sharath, to the webinar. And before Sharath takes over, let me tell you, do you know that an accomplished Kathakali dancer can move their eyeballs in 17 different ways, their eyebrows in 8 different ways, and their eyelids in another 8 different ways? It's mind-boggling what these people can do, accomplished Kathakali artists can do. For the uninitiated, I know you know what Kathakali is, but still for the uninitiated, Kathakali is a dance form indigenous to Kerala, colorful and dramatic in content and character. Scenes from Indian epics and mythology are the themes for the dance. Let me just go straight to Sharath. Sharath, there are 7 classical dances in India and Kathakali is one of them. How is a dance categorized as a classical dance in India?
First of all, namaskaram, and I express my sincere thanks and gratitude for having given me this opportunity to be with you and interact with you, whatever information and knowledge I have within my limits, because as a human being, especially kind of an art form like Kathakali, it requires you know, years of training, and I think to know Kathakali you need a lot of rebirths again and again. So I'm not sure, you know, I could master something of this. You know, I have just entered the edge of that paper, Kathakali, in fact, because it's an ocean. And Kathakali, when it is not a mere classical dance, actually it's a dance drama or a ballet. And if you classify, you know, the complete art forms, like if you talk about music, if you talk about painting, if you talk about sculpture, and the orchestration, then drama, then theater. So it's a collage or a combination of all these independent, different, complete art forms. So that is why Kathakali is being addressed as art of arts. So and it needs a very high amount of training to become a Kathakali dancer, as well as to become an audience of Kathakali also. basically one needs to know the story in and out fully. Then he needs to have knowledge about the kind of movements of characters, expressions, the hand gestures, and these kind of things. And so it needs a training for performer as well as the viewer, both together. So that's why it is being classified as a classical art, because the people who can really have that knowledge can get along and enjoy the art form. And even some of the audience have become the critics also. And it is another main thing. An artist in Kathakali, because when you compare with other ballets and dramas or everything, you have a lot of directors and the assistant directors and all. In Kathakali, the performer himself is the director. He is an actor as well as the director and the choreographer. And Kathakali is the only art form in the world where the individual artists enjoy the unrestricted freedom on the stage to use his spontaneous improvisation. So he can improvise so many things on the stage, but only restriction that whatever be the improvisation, it should be suitable to the mood of the character as well as that particular theme and that particular timing. And accordingly, he can improvise anything. So he needs to be not only a good learner of Kathakali and its languages and expressions, he needs to be a good observer of the universe, because he needs to improvise about the parrot or the peacock or something. So as much as he observes its movements and everything, because he has to recreate the movements of the same things on the stage. So he must be a good observer and he must be a good reader, and he must be a good, he must be able to understand every aspect of life, expressions, emotions, especially with regard to the characters.
Sarath, we will come more to that. You said something very interesting here. You said that to enjoy Kathakali, even the audience needs a little bit of training. Can you tell our audience what is that kind of training you will, because this is like something very interesting. I want the audience to know more what they need to kind of imbibe or train themselves a little bit to enjoy the Kathakali.
In good old days, the training was, it was not a specific training which was happening for audience,
right,
any of the organization. It was by practice. In good old days, this was the only entertainment form. And people, they must know the stories, each and every story fully, and each and every character absolutely, about the methods and themes and the stories. So by seeing for some years, they get practiced. They get practice to see and enjoy the performance of Kathakali. But now the opportunity, the lifestyle has changed. So now we started some kind of movement of, like familiarization of Kathakali gestures, what it means. Because once you know the story and the character, it, you can get along with the performance and and the theme. Once you know the theme and the character and its mentality and expressions, you can follow. But the hand gestures, and it's a specific kind of dance movements. And when I am talking about dance in Kathakali, it is not just a mere dance. It is part of the language of Kathakali, because every dance form by footwork, the other parts of the bodies are also involved in that, but it's all designed to suit various kinds of emotions of the character as well as the scene at that particular time.
Right. So you were saying that in the good old days, people actually knew this hand gesture. People actually knew this stories. People actually used to know this whole design.
Yes.
Right.
Exactly.
So I'm coming back to the good old days. Give us a little bit of the historical background of Kathakali. How did it come up, and its evolution?
When we talk about the historical background, according to my knowledge, the first performing theater, which is about 3,000 years old, which is Koodiyattam, which is a Sanskrit theater, which is a living legend now, recognized by UN. And that was purely very classified, and people who knew Sanskrit could follow that particular art form, Koodiyattam. So Koodiyattam is a starting art form of these kind of, you know, imaginary characters and the kind of makeups and costumes what we are seeing now in Kathakali. And after Koodiyattam, we happened to have a Krishnanattam, which was fully restricted to Guruvayur temple under Zamorin, King of Zamorin, Calicut. And this was for, I think, last for 50 years before it was completely restricted only in Guruvayur temple, or rather sometimes in the feudal families, family houses. And that was purely Krishnan. Atam means Krishna, it's about Lord Krishna. Atam means dance. So there was no such kind of a drama was there, any kind of, the stories used to be performed, but with full of dance, with various costumes and characters. It was full of, but there is no drama in it. And when Krishnanattam was very popular, one of the king of Kottarakara, he invited this troupe to perform at his palace. But as you know, there was always jealous between the kings. So the Zamorin actually replied to Kottarakara king that, you know, I don't mind to send, but there is no one to understand this Krishnanattam, because it needs to know Sanskrit. That means, you know, in those days, people who know Sanskrit means only literate people. So this was really an insult to the Kottarakara king. So he felt very bad, and he started writing Ramanattam and the stories about Rama. Then he imitated, he took some of the costumes and the makeup things, everything from Krishnanattam and Koodiyattam and everything. He started performing Ramanattam, and gradually this Ramanattam became Kathakali.
Right.
Kathakali doesn't have any kind of, the restrictions like what Krishnanattam was having, because Kathakali was purely, Krishnanattam was, even now it has got a lot of religious disciplines. And Kathakali has got devotional disciplines, but it doesn't have any kind of restrictions. Kathakali was considered as purely an entertainment program. And it used to perform wherever it required, and any get-togethers or any celebrations, Kathakali used to be performed, and that was one of the reason Kathakali got popularized, and it could reach to the people as much as possible in good old days. Could reach to the maximum village, you know, in various corners and in various temples of the villages. So Kathakali was popularized like that.
Right.
And Krishnanattam.
Right. And if you look at the Kathakali artists like that we are seeing on the screen right now, it's full of drama. I mean, look at the costumes, look at the makeup. Kathakali, every character has a specific makeup, you know. This, can you tell us more how did this concept come about why is the face always green but not any other color, for example?
There are so many other colors,
right?
But first of all, when we classify, basically this green makeup indicates royal or noble characters like kings or gods,
right?
And there is another peculiar type of makeup that is a scissor like pattern painted in red colors on the cheeks and nose and forehead, and rest of the part covered by green, and that indicates outside a very nice gentleman but inside a very very bad man, a kind of a villain,
right?
And the full black is for hunters from the forest kind of characters, and the other character is red one, which is the most fearful kind of makeup, which is a very wicked characters. Maybe slight variations will be there according to the characters. So, you know, different asuras comes, maybe slight variations in paintings may be there, but these are the basic classifications. And the sandalwood type of color is used for the most sober characters, like the lady characters and the munis, you know, the saints and rishis and kind of things.
Right, very very interesting. And I would like to
add another thing.
Yeah,
there is, we are not using any sort of you know, synthetic materials to make these colors. It's all made out of natural minerals,
right?
And natural minerals with coconut oil, and even everything is natural, eco-friendly, because we don't use any plastic brush. We are using the stem of the, you know, the coconut palm leaves, and the coconut palm leaves we use for the stem of that we use as a brush for making up. So everything is eco-friendly. We are using nothing of plastic or synthetic materials are being used. And the main mineral which we are using for making colors, that is called maniola. I don't have the English translation actually. We call it as maniola. It looks like sulfur, but it is not sulfur, but it definitely comes under sulfur, I believe. And we were being told that it is one of the most powerful antiseptic medicine too.
Right.
And it's from the our own experience, it shows that, because you know, the costume setup, the maintenance of costume is very very costly. It's not simple thing. So the kind of costumes, a set of Kathakali costumes means, you know, comprises about 12 to 15 characters sets, and those sets used to have only with certain families who were having so much of money, the feudal system, who were the patrons of these kind of art forms. But the artists used to change, and they used to wear the same old dresses. But so far, as on today, Kathakali, no Kathakali artists have been identified with any kind of diseases using the same costumes. So
right.
The maniola is one of the most powerful antiseptic medicine which is being used on the face, which produces a lot of heat also. And the black is a carbon collected on a terracotta from the ghee lamp, which actually gives a good eyesight for the artist. So these are basic colors.
Right, and that's a Kathakali dancer for you on the screen.
Yeah.
One thing that I would like to ask you, Sharath, what are the characters that you have played as a Kathakali dancer, and which one is your favorite and why, if any?
I have played almost all characters as of now, because if I tell my story a little bit, because from childhood, you know, because in our family, especially in Kerala, Hindu families, the grandmas, you know, after the morning kitchen work and everything, say about 9:30, 10 onwards, they used to read Bhagavad Purana, Ramayana and everything. So at childhood, you know, my grandma used to call me and be with her and just hear. Though I didn't understand anything what she was reading, this Bhagavad Purana and everything, But sometimes I could feel that she was weeping. Sometimes she was crying. She was smiling, and a lot of emotions were there. Maybe the stories of Krishna and everything. And slowly, slowly, I started questioning about what is the reason for crying, what is the reason for laughing. So she used to translate the stories like about Krishna, Arjuna, and all these characters. So right. These surrealistic characters were somehow came into my mind, in my subconscious mind, and it was well placed there. And I think at the age of 5 or 6, my dad took me to watch a Kathakali show in a temple. So really I was astonished, you know, because the characters which were in my mind, in subconscious mind, I could see them on the stage. So that's how I slowly, slowly attached to this art form. And first I was the appreciator of the front stage. Then slowly I began to peep behind the curtain, what is happening. And I was wondering whether it was a real human being or not. That was my curiousness. Then when I happened to be in the green room, I could see that it's all people like me and getting painted and getting dressed and coming back. And this was really inspiring me, and which inspired me to start Kathakali course for me and to start study Kathakali. So after starting Kathakali with rigorous training, with oil massage and everything, it's training with my master, as I said, Kalamandalam Vasudevan and other Padmasri Kalamandalam Krishna Nair. I have performed almost all the stories, but somehow, first of all, I must say that the classification, you know, like in doctors, you know, the specialization like gynecologist, nephrologist and things, you can choose. But in Kathakali, it is not the choice of an artist alone. It is the choice of the audience also. Because audience who liked the character of that particular artist, that he has to specialize. So audiences are the main source of specialization of character, which an individual artist has to perform. So somehow I think the Lord Krishna was, my performance was well appreciated across. So my mastered character was Lord Krishna.
So that's your favorite. So that became your favorite character, right? Everybody appreciated that.
Favorite character, and I think the video which you played initially in that somewhere that Krishna and Kujala was performing, the camera was behind. That Krishna was me.
Okay. Right.
That was my performance.
Right. Very interesting. I didn't know about it. One thing that I would like to talk about now is, Sharad, in the early days, women were not allowed to perform Kathakali. Yeah. Why was that? And how do you say things are changing now? Because if you talk about this particular Kathakali school in Tripunthura, they have all women Kathakali dance troupe who goes around performing entire country, and they've been very well received.
Yeah. No, it was not the mere history or the story of Kathakali. Even Shakespeare drama, women were not performing, you know. Because in those days, it was a kind of a social discipline. The women, they were not allowed to go out, and they were not allowed to have education. They were not allowed to have some kind of performance or external appearance. So even in Shakespeare theaters, you know, the women were not allowed. So the same thing was happening here. Very, you know, in the feudal families and other, the women were not having that much freedom to go and perform. And another thing, as I said, as a devotional discipline, there are certain occasions, you know, the women can't fully combine with that kind of devotional disciplines, especially the menstrual seasons and everything. And Kathakali as an art form, it needs a very intensive training. As you have seen, it is very nice to see the performance because the artist is performing with colorful hot makeup, with the weight of costumes of like about 40 to 50 kilograms. So that was also one of the reasons, and the performance lasts the whole night. So that was also one of the reasons where women were not able to catch up with these art forms. And even in Tamil Nadu and all, you know, it was termed in a, the dancers, female dancers were addressed as a bad woman. But that has been changed after a lot of evolutions and revolutions. And the people could really understand the value of art and its philosophies and everything. So that kind of changes started happening in Kerala also, like in other parts of the world. And I think now for last 60 to 70 years before the women started coming to Kerala, I mean Kathakali, and started performing. And they have formed a group in Tripunithra. Now, not only in Tripunithra, now you can assemble a group even from different parts of Kerala, because there are a lot of women artists are also coming up in Kathakali and well performing, including my sister is one of the prominent performer in women Kathakali artist. And so there are a lot of women are also coming up, but still there are quite some kind of limitations to handle some characters, especially some heavy characters in Kathakali, by wearing these heavy makeup and heavy costumes. And the characters like Ravana and Naragasura, the kind of characters which is there for 3 to 4 or 5 hours continuously on the stage, there are still some limitations to handle such characters. Otherwise, women are also participating nowadays in Kathakali very much.
Right. And there was this lady called Haripriya Nambudri.
Yeah.
Yeah. So she is also quite famous, isn't it, as a Kathakali dancer?
Yeah. She has just took her PhD, but she is good, but not that famous, I can say, because she started her classes only at a very later stage. I think not that much experienced she herself as a Kathakali artist.
Right. And I'm now going to, you already told me about the inspiration behind you getting into Kathakali. I'm going to come to that later, but this mudras, which is this hand gestures, I remember that afternoon with you. You told me that the different mudras, which are the hand gestures used in Kathakali, are also known to have health benefits. Can you tell us more about this?
Yeah, I can tell you about some 2, 3 mudras, because basically I need, it needs a lot of time as well as. And
yeah, maybe you can show some mudras which we can try while we are maybe sitting or in a bus or in a car or something.
Mudra, basically mudra is a Sanskrit word. And literally it means seal. And it's a symbolic or ritual gesture in Hinduism and Buddhism. And some mudras involve the entire body and some only with hand and facial movements, some with hands and the legs. So mudra means it is actually a spiritual gesture and energetic seal of authenticity employed in this iconography and spiritual practice in Hinduism as well as Taoism. So that's why even, you know, the scientists used to keep this, you know, for a while doing, you know, the meditation and everything. The people used to keep like this. or like this. Even in Kathakali also, when we do the Hanuman and kind of things, we used to hold like this. And this in, but the it's all came from Vedic literature and Tantric. And Kathakali has adopted some of the gestures from this Tantric. Bharatanatyam has adopted, like all other dance forms have adopted from different books and different styles in fact. And generally, the mudras, what I found that it's all designed based on the physiology of an individual human being. Because each and every movement of your body makes different kind of blood circulations and different rhythms of your heart. Even if you hold like this, that's why even nowadays you might be very much knowing that, you know, if you go to cardiologist, he used to say that hold like this and do this. And this is a gesture in Kathakali also. We call it mushti. This one. So the doctors nowadays say that, you know, you practice like this. And this is called mudrakyam in Kathakali language, in our language. The thumb with the first finger, that is mudrakya. And this is called mudra of knowledge, jnan mudra. That's why in all meditations and everything, we keep these mudras as a gesture for knowledge, as a mudra for knowledge. And this increases, actually, when you keep like this and give pressure on both the thumbs, you know, the where it is joining, and you can practice yourself, and it says that, you know, it can increase your memory power and knowledge gaining power. That is the first one. And this is the first gesture in Kathakali. And Kathakali, this is a common gesture where for even for dance forms and even for dialogues and for all performance, generally we are using this, the Gyan Mudra, the knowledge, the Mudra of knowledge. The second one which I can tell you is Vayu Mudra, Mudra of air. That is, hold the first finger like this and the thumb like this. So in Kathakali, for which word we are using means, you know, you use like this. This means everywhere. What is the relevance? Why it is being adopted in Kathakali? Vayu means air. It is everywhere. So for everywhere, this particular mudra for Vayu has been taken, and with a aesthetic sense, it made some kind of designing of mudra and says Vayu everywhere. Yeah, another one. This is means shaking. And with air, it can shake anything. With a heavy air, you know, it can shake anything. So in Kathakali, it's all designed from those kind of meanings also. And even from the meaning of Vedic literature also, in Kathakali, these gestures are being adopted. This is called Vayu Mudra. This is called Mudra of Jnan, Jnan Mudra, Mudra of knowledge. And this is Mudra of air.
And what is the health relevance of the air Vayu Mudra? What is the health benefit of the Vayu Mudra?
That is good for rheumatism, anything connected with air, any disease connected with air. It has to say that, you know, you have to go and do these practices. Like rheumatism, arthritis, or Parkinson's disease.
Right. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Thank you for showing us. Again, coming to the different gestures. Let's talk about the various movements of the eyeballs, eyebrows, and even eyelids. Does each movement have some significance? If yes, what? And can you show us some movements as well of the eyes?
See, the eye movement, all these movements put together comes as facial expressions, navarasas or the bhavas or abhinayas. And while we are getting trained, you know, it's all being trained independently. For example, I will say, and the picture which you have now showing is my colleague artist, Mr. Mohan, who is performing daily in for your guest in my center. The eye movement is, one is this in round,
which is not easy as it looks. It's very difficult, let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, in its practice.
The same way, on the other way, then towards both the sides. It comes in different speeds. Then top, I'm just showing the main movements. Then comes corners. Now, how you can write 8 with your eyes. Then towards front and back, front and back, front and back. So these are the main kind of eye movements.
Then it's the eyes which says everything, right? The eye says a lot of things, you would agree.
For a writer, you need a pen.
Right.
And as an actor, my pen is my eyes.
Right.
Simple form. The pen is being replaced with my eyes. Otherwise, you can't read.
Fantastic. Sharath, you told us about the inspiration, your grandmother, what she used to read after lunch, that kind of inspired you in the world of Kathakali. But now what you have shown us, how rigorous was the training? Give us an idea of how rigorous was the training, so that people know that that you have to train for years and years, and actually the training never stops till you die.
Yeah, of course, no doubt. Because it starts, the morning starts at 3 o'clock.
Wow.
And from 3, you start doing your physical exercises.
And what are those physical exercises?
Physical exercise is almost like connected to Kalaripayat.
Okay.
Kalaripayat kind of exercises, the kind of sitting and jumping and all those kind of exercises for an hour. Then, which will be again another 1 hour, the basic footworks and the body movements. Because in Kathakali, it says wherever the body goes, the mind has to go that side. Now, when for example, if my hand goes like this, my mind should go at least 10 kilometers away from me. Then only my eye can go 2 kilometers. So everything should be well choreographed. So it is designed in that way. So 4 to 5 is that kind of exercises, which will be followed by the massage, the foot massage. The massage will be done with the foot, which is a very heavy massage. And after that, you will have to go for the bath and your breakfast and everything, and come back. Then you start learning the dance, basic dances involved in Kathakali. And by 10 o'clock onwards, till about 1 o'clock, you have characters performance, different characters to be performed. Then 1 to 2 is the lunch, and 2 to 3 again, you have 2 to 4, you have literature classes, like about Sanskrit and its meanings, what exactly, because the independent individual dancer must know everything by heart. Because the conversation is written in the language, which is a mixture of Sanskrit and Malayalam. So he must by heart everything. So he must know the meaning of everything. So the literature class. Then again, 4 o'clock, you have got a tea break. Then about 5 to 7, you have again the dance movements and classes. Then 7 o'clock, you have prayer. Then from 7:30 to 9:30, you have the facial makeup classes. Then go for dinner and then sleep about 10 o'clock. Then start again in the morning, 3 o'clock.
And that went on for how long with you?
That is for 6 to 8 years minimum.
6 to 8 years. Wow. 6 to 8 years, you are actually
minimum. Basic.
You are living, breathing only Kathakali. There is nothing else, right?
Nothing.
Wow, that's like that's very rigorous and very
and needs a very high amount of commitment also
and motivation. And how do you keep yourself motivated every day? I mean, you go to sleep at 10 o'clock, wake up at 3, and do the same regime year after year after year for 6 to 8 years. How do you keep yourself? How did you keep yourself motivated?
No, it is like, it's a kind of a competition. Automatically, the competitions will come. Who will do maximum number of jumps? Who will do maximum? See, suppose the footwork exercises, somebody does continuously without stopping 20 minutes. So my attempt is, if I can stop the last person, then I can become the champion. So in different disciplines, those kind of thoughts will motivate you.
Right.
Another thing, these surrealistic characters and the stories are really more motivating, actually. That is from childhood onwards, that stories are motivated. So how best you can study those legendary characters, because you can study one by one. So how best you can become a reputed, recognized artist? That is another motivation, because people started looking at you. Oh, he is coming. He is and identified as an artist. After 8 years, it is not easy to be identified. You'll have to prove it on the stage.
Right.
And the audience will accept.
Right. And what happens on the last day of passing out? Do you do a performance and then your guru is sitting and watching?
Yeah. There is no question of last day. It's actually after.
I mean, the last day at that institute or the school at Kalamandalam.
The last day the performance is there and the guru is there, and you have to give that guru dakshina, and you get a certificate. Nowadays it's all being institutionalized, so the certificates are there. In good old days, there was no such certificates. And the Guru Dakshina, after paying Guru Dakshina, you leave. But you have the scope of coming back always whenever to meet with gurus, because you are going that, but only for that particular day. The next night performance somewhere in the temples, you will be again joining with those gurus and again performing.
Right. Okay, let me ask you, what is that one thing you carried with you from this rigorous experience of yours from 6 to 8 years?
It is quite, because how best artistically and aesthetically you can view the life, and how easily you can be away from the provocations, and how best you can enjoy the poetries, and how best you can dream. That's the main.
Wow.
How best you can dream. Because sometimes, as Robin was saying, what to do nowadays in COVID, the dreaming is one of the best thing.
So Kathakali helps you to dream.
Yeah, of course. You can. How beautifully you can dream.
No, I you touched upon some very important points here. Kathakali helps you to dream. It keeps you away from all kinds of provocation, and you look at life in a completely different way, in a more aesthetic and in a more artistic way. Fantastic.
Yeah.
I may
just play one video for you.
Please.
The present legendary maestro Padma Shri Kalamandalam Gobi, who is
right.
completed his 84 years old, but he is busy in the nights.
Wow. How old is he?
He completed his 84.
And he's still learning and he's still performing.
Still performing. I think in 365 days, at least he'll be performing at least 225 performance in any year.
Wow. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stop sharing my screen, and you can start playing your video.
Yeah.
Just remember that you need to share the sound of your computer for us to hear.
Yeah. I will do that.
I'm just stopping share here.
Yeah. Legendary.
In Kathakali, face is very important. I told you that we have to present a story on stage. While presenting the story on stage, there will be different moods, different contexts. Sometimes there will be happy, sometimes there will be angry. So different moods are there. The artist face has to take the same expression. For that purpose, we have Navarasas. 9 facial expressions. Ubhyashari is going to show you Navarasas. The first among the 9, Shringara, that is showing love, happy, pleasure,
romantic.
Second one, he said, is harsyam, that is criticizing.
Contempt.
Third one, his name is karuna, that is crying, weeping.
Pathos.
Horror.
Next one is Roundram, angry mood.
Yeah.
next word, that is Veeram, heroic, kingly expression.
Valor, bravery. Fear. Life.
Next, Albudam.
Wonder.
Last word, ninth word is Shandam, peace, meditation.
Tranquility.
Facial expressions. We have one more, that is, his name is Lajja, that is shyness, shy.
Apart from Nayan, there is one more bhava called shyness. Shy.
That was wonderful. Thank you for playing this with us. I'm going to share my screen now and continue. Sharat, what we saw were the nine emotions. Can you tell us more about what is the Navarasa, about the Natya Shastra, a little bit in brief for our audience?
Navarasas are basic nine human emotions classified as per the Natya Shastra. And Natya Shastra, many people think that it is only for art, but it is a book for common man, which is considered as fifth Veda, which talks about everything of human life. Natya Shastra, though it is named as Natya Shastra, is not just mere for dancers. It is for the whole common man, and it talks about how a man should be and what should be. Even it says the properties and props, like what do you mean by a bedroom, and those kind of things. Everything is in a scientific, as a Veda, it says how it has to be, and that is Natya Shastra actually. So where Navarasa comes as a branch, the human emotions, when we talk about human emotions. So the nine emotions, what you have seen now. So that is just common romance or love. But the love, for an artist, it is more difficult, because when you express love between a father and a son, or a mother and a son, or a husband and wife, or a lover and lover, and these are all varies. So that subtle changes of your eyes and expressions or movements, the one which you have seen Sringara, what he has shown, is the basic thing. But it varies again based on the character which we represent, to whom we are expressing. So, and suppose we are, you know, exclamatory romance, sometimes it happens. You are going, you are the king is entering to a garden with full of greenery and with full of flowers and things. You know, he is again, the basic rasa is romance, but it's an exclamatory romance, you know. So that there are a lot of subtle changes has to be made on while expressing on the stage. That is the success of an artist, where the people actually, I must say, with these 9 emotions, the dancer, he never cries on the stage. He make audience to cry. That is the basic principle of Nati Shastra. Because you are not losing yourself. You are always aware that you are, I am Sharad Kumar. And I am representing only, I am presenting a character, Krishna. But I need to make you to cry when Krishna is crying. That is the success of an artist.
Right. And very, very interesting what you're saying right now.
Yeah.
That it is the artist is aware, but it's the artist who makes the audience cry. Sharad, coming to the current scenario, are people still interested in learning this dance? What are the challenges faced in keeping up this tradition?
No, nowadays the thing is the acceptance, social acceptance. Now that challenge is somewhat, it is getting over, because people are slowly coming back to maybe as a fashion or whatever it may be. Now a lot of people, young generation is coming back to Kathakali and the old systems and the old kind of art forms, at least the old kind of rich art forms, which they might have identified as it is, has got a rich heritage. So the people are slowly coming back to that heritage, and only now it is spreading. But the problem is, it is again losing the deathness. That is the problem which I am worrying. It is now spreading, but the deathness is reducing. In good old days, spreading was not much, but the death was much. So, which helped artists also to get refined a lot, you know, because you need a good lot of critics also to be a writer or to be a performer. So now the role of critics are reducing, because the deathness of information or knowledge, but it is spreading a lot. That is the present scenario.
Okay, so the positive thing is that it's spreading, but the depth is good. It's losing its depth, you were saying.
Yeah.
What do you mean by it's losing its depth?
Because now people should, according to me, you know, there should not be like, you know, like in films, you know, the Shah Rukh Khan fans and another Amitabh Bachchan fans. Now a lot of fans associations are coming up. Instead of becoming fan, one needs to be a good-hearted person with knowledge of story, and critically view whether any artists have done any justice to that character or not with his knowledge, for which he needs to have a depth of knowledge, how he handled the character, how he handled that particular scene. And so those kind of things has to be considered instead of becoming fans.
Right. Are you saying that a lot of people who are not properly trained are getting into the scene?
Yeah, very much.
Okay, so that's how, what you mean that when there is no depth, that people who are not really trained are now getting into the scene. Well, yeah. It's happening in, the Cochin Cultural Center, where we send our guests.
Yeah.
It was established by your father in 1978 has been awarded with the Kerala Tourism Excellence Award for being the best performing arts center by the Department of Tourism. Yeah. You too have recently received an award for being the International Communicator of the Year 2020 in the field of performing arts presented by the International Public Relations Council. What was the inspiration behind this, behind the Cochin Cultural Center, and how has the journey been for you so far?
No, in fact, my father was an absolutely a businessman. He was an electrical businessman, and the whole congratulation should go to him if I happen to be something now in the field of Kathakali. Because as a one and only son, usually you know very well, you know, a businessman or the family never send him for these kind of fantasies. But he identified. He never wanted me and arrested me to be a businessman and put me into his business. He just asked me, what is your interest? And this is, he identified my interest, but only thing is, he was saying that if you study, you should study in depth. And at least you should come in the one among the five in the art form. And that should be, I don't mind if, even if you come, if you become Kathakali artist, instead of being a businessman or my follower. That's what his treatment. And when I was studying, then he could see that, you know, I am taking a lot of interest, and he thought that, you know, something has to be made for me instead of electrical business, you know, something suitable for me. So he started an academy called the Cochin Cultural Center along with my master those days. And that went well. And the late M.K.K. Nair, perhaps you might be knowing, was one of the chieftain IAS officer. And he was saying that, you know, you should, in that time it was only an academy, and he was saying that, why don't you start evening some small piece of performance? Whatever the authentic way you do it, even if it is for an half an hour or 1 hour, do it. Because people who are coming out of Kerala, out of India, when they are visiting Cochin, they must be given some opportunity to know the performing arts of Kerala. Right. So this made me to think, and we started performing from 1978 onwards. So that's how it's doing still good, and people are appreciating. And with my experience, I have made my own style of presenting the performance, because in my center, wherever I go for the performance in the late night, but only after the center's performance, after 7:30. So I myself is presenting the performance personally. So that's in a very typical way. So my idea behind that performance is that within that 1 hour, the person who comes and sits and watch the performance, when he leaves, he must get FIR on Kathakali, first information report.
Right.
That's how I have designed my performance in my center.
Right, perfect. And my last question to you will be, apart from your Cochin Cultural Center, which is a center and academy, where would you say is the best place in Kerala to witness an authentic Kathakali dance performance?
You mean the real traditional way, in the whole night shows across Kerala? There are a lot of temples.
Right.
In the festival season, anybody comes, they can definitely watch Kathakali performance in temples.
Right.
Otherwise, they will have to come to the center like me. Mm-hmm. And there are similar centers also there, like me in Cochin and some other areas of Kerala. But I'm not the best person to judge me. It is you to judge and tell me which is the best.
Right. And any other place in Kerala which is known for its Kathakali dancers?
there is no specific place because now, as I said, it is spreaded across Kerala. So in, if it is a festival time, you can definitely, you can have these performances and artists you can meet.
Right. Okay, thank you so much for that lovely presentation, Sharath. I think we have a lot of questions today. I can already see 12 questions. Let's kind of take them one by one. Manish Gandhi is asking, hello, Mr. Sharath, we can relate the Kathakali dance form to the flamenco dance form of Spain in Europe. Because professionally, when we include Kathakali experience in our program, he works for the Spanish market. And whenever we are asked about it, we use the analogy of flamenco dance because both are dance, because both the dance forms are highly expressive dance forms using body movements. And once our guests experience it, they give the feedback that Kathakali is much more rigorous, which we have understood in detail. In we have understood its detail today in your presentation. So he's just thanking you and he's just sharing your experience about Kathakali with vis-a-vis his Spanish clients. Chandra Shekhar is asking, hi Sharath Ji, thanks for this knowledgeable presentation. Apart from costume and makeup, there are a lot of facial expressions which are a part of this performance. Can you tell us with the time, is there any kind of change or modernization of this art?
No, the kind of modernization only can possible in this art nowadays, it is only with the lighting system. Because when this art was started, say about 400 to 500 years before, this was being performed with big oil lamp. So considering the available light, all these costumes are being designed and the makeup is designed, which absolutely fantastic for creating a surrealistic, you know, appearance and the scene. Now what happens after that, the electricity has come. Now the people started using electricity, electrical lights. But I, in my center, I spend a lot of money for that. And I have made a specific lighting system with a restricted lighting system, because you know you don't need to have a full bashing lights, you know, a lot of lights on the stage, which will definitely kills the beauty of the costumes and makeup. So you need to have a very restricted kind of lighting system, which is already I made in my centers.
Right,
and modernization, you can do it,
and
through which you can have a lot of dramas also, because the real drama you can make with, as somebody said, you know, because shadow, whether you any cameraman and you know will answer, I think one of the intelligent cameramen said, I like shadows, because shadow is actually making you to identify you, your curves.
Right, interesting. Chandra Shekhar is again asking, it takes minimum 8 years, as you said. Do you think that the new generation have this kind of patience? And how do you see their future prospect in this art?
Now the new generation, because Kalamandalam is already made as a deemed university. So the old system of having these three o'clock morning to evening 10 o'clock, it's all changed. Now everything has become a university level because the government has taken over Kalamandalam. So the it is running as an you know, other kind of universities, and they are getting deemed university certificates, which can be used for any other employment also. So that's why I initially told you that it is spreading, but the depthness is reducing.
Right. Exactly. Rashmi Gupta is asking, you talked about Guru Dakshina after the rigorous trainings. What is that Guru Dakshina that you
it
give?
It is an offer. It is an offering.
Once yeah, but what do you give as Guru Dakshina?
That is, you know, that that leaves, you know, which pan?
Beetle leaf.
Beetle leaves.
Yeah.
And whatever possible money you have, and with two dhotis.
Okay, two dhotis.
Yeah.
Right. Fascinating. This is what we generally offer to elders also as Guru Dakshina everywhere in India. Avinash Kumar is asking, Hi Sharadji, Vanaprastham was a remarkable and awarded movie based on the life of a Kathakali artist.
Yeah.
What are your views? Has the movie done justice in explaining the culture and the depth of this mesmerizing art?
Absolutely, absolutely. Because, you know, because that in the nutshell of that movie, that lady, the queen, is having an affair with that artist when he is in costume. And after, when he removes his costumes, she even doesn't recognize him. So that's what I am saying. I said earlier that my consciousness should not go. But whenever I am on the stage, I don't have to cry. But I should make the others to cry. So that is what established.
So that's what was the story of Vanaprastham. I have not seen the movie, but definitely I...
Yeah, it was good. It was nicely done. Nice movie.
Right. Vipul Saxena is asking, Sharadji, please tell us, are there any Kathakali plays from epics from outside Kerala, maybe in Europe, maybe a European play in a Kathakali way? Has it been performed that way?
Yeah, it has produced, but not performed regularly. It has been produced and performed like King Lear, Snow White, Cinderella, Macbeth. It's all produced.
In traditional Kathakali style?
In traditional Kathakali style.
Have you done something like this? Can you do something like this for our clients?
Because that won't fit to our timing. That's only... Yeah. And another thing, once I tried, the people who are coming from outside India wanted to see our own epics and culture, you know.
Right.
That's the problem.
Right. Ritika Gupta is asking, thank you for the nice presentation. As we know that Kathakali has five major veshams.
Yeah.
Kathi, Pacha, Thaddi, Minukwan, Kari. Can you please explain about these Veshams?
Yeah, that's what I said. Pacha is the green one, which is sober characters like king or god. And Kathi is a villain character. That is a scissor-like pattern painted on the cheeks, nose and forehead in red color, rest of the part covered by green. And Thaddi is the red one as well as the black one, both beards, which has got beards, Thaddi. And Minuku for these rishis, munis, and lady characters.
Right. Anil Chauhan has two questions. Question number one, can you name some people who introduced innovations in Kathakali and brought it to the standard that it is performed today?
There is no question of innovation. Innovation is happening in Kathakali. When you talk about in terms of performance, innovation is happening every day in on every stage by every artist, and mostly the successful artists. That's what I was saying, that, you know, there was a question from one of your client long time before when I was performing. He was showing that how many stories. Oh, these typical stories are being performed for 4 to 5 centuries, but you still have audience. I said the same stories are being performed by the same artist sometimes, but from one day to the other day, his approach to that character or the theme or for the scene may be different. Or if it is a different artist, again, that difference is going to be reflected.
So there is a lot of, so it's not just one standardized kind of constant innovation depending on the artist, right?
Yes, very much, very much. That's why he must be a good observer, he must be a good reader, he must be a good thinker.
So basically the Krishna that you will dance yeah. And Krishna, someone else will perform, will be completely different, though they are Kathakali artists.
Yeah. Because his approach to Krishna and my approach to Krishna may be different, you know.
Anil Chauhan is again asking, this is an interesting question, why does Kathakali dance happen only in the evening?
That was the purely when it was originated, because this Koodiyattam and all these things, because the daytime and everything, people used to work. So the entertainment slot was only in the nights. So the tradition was in the nights. Even it can perform in the daytime, there is no harm.
So there is no restriction about the timings?
No, not at all.
And you mentioned that Kathakali is, it has its devotional tenets, but it's still entertainment, right? So yes, entertainment can be at any point of the day. Okay, all right. Ashish Swarnagar is asking, how much time does an artist take to complete his or her makeup?
At least 3 to 4 hours.
And how much time to take off the makeup?
Take off the makeup is only 10 minutes.
Okay. And how do you take off the makeup, if I may ask? Do you use a particular coconut oil, or how do you do it?
We apply coconut oil, and with the cotton waste, we take out.
Right.
It is like constructing twin tower and demolishing the twin tower.
Right. Sharadji, another question from Bipul Saxena. Bipul Saxena is asking his question. It is believed that the hand gestures are performed to the words of the padam.
Yeah.
But how would one relate with the hand gesture to the words of padam? Will the gestures be repeated as the lines in a padam are repeated?
Yeah, definitely. Because as I said, this is a gesture for all, or for everything. And whenever that padam comes, this gesture repeats.
Right. Vikas Solanki is asking, some people say that Kabuki, a Japanese art form, is similar to Kathakali. Is it true?
Yes, it is. It is very much true. Because I was there in Tokyo for 3 months. So I happened to work with some of the Kabuki theaters and artists. So it is almost the same. Even I had my idea of making something new as a fusion of Kabuki and Kathakali in Mahabharata.
Oh, that's your plan?
I'm thinking, I don't know whether I will succeed or not, because
that sounds fantastic. a fusion of Kabuki and Kathakali and Mahabharata. Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Ritika Gupta is asking, what are your suggestions or views to attract our new generation towards Kathakali?
You mean the local generation is already attracted, because they have already, now we have good amount of people are coming. And even as somebody told me sometime before, the timing, if the whole night timing is a problem, then the timing can be reduced. Even it can be from 6 to 9:30, 10, or even before that, even afternoon 2 to 6 o'clock in Sundays. Those kind of things can be definitely made, and that kind of experiments are already happening now in different temples also.
Right. Avinash Kumar is asking another question, Sharadji, why Kathakali is related to Koodiyattam and Krishnattam? Avinash, we already touched upon this during the early part of our presentation.
I didn't get your question.
Yeah, no, he's asking, is Kathakali related to Koodiyattam and Krishnattam? Yeah, we talked about it. We talked about it, right? We talked about it at the beginning of the presentation. You see the recording, Avinash. Firoz Khan is asking, my question is, when can one start learning Kathakali dance form? How early can you start?
At least he must be 12 or 13 years old, because there are a lot of mathematical calculations are there with regard to rhythm and footwork and movements. So one should be able to recognize those kind of mathematics.
Right. So basically, 13 years is a good time to start, but then you can always start early, right? It's not a problem.
Yeah, you can.
So Jaydeep Singh Rawat again shares his experience that he once attended a Kathakali performance in Delhi based on Draupadi Chirharan, an episode from the Mahabharata, and he was completely taken aback by their eye movements and facial expressions. Thank you, Jaydeep, for sharing your experience. Sharad, Vipinayal is asking, apart from Indians, which other nationals do you find taking more interest in Indian classical dances, including Kathakali?
I think French people are more, French, Italians, and British, and Japanese also. Japanese are also taking good interest in these kind of art forms. But mainly with regard to art, what I found in my years of experience, French and Italian people are more into these kind of arts.
Right, that's from your experience. Vipin Nayal again is asking, you are a Kathakali maestro yourself, but if we talk about the seven classical dance forms, which is the next one that you really like?
I like Bharatanatyam.
Right, and what is the reason?
Because it has got, again, it gives more opportunity for, you know, the single dancer to describe the whole story. Again, like Kathakali, the individual dancer has got the opportunity to use his improvising skill.
Right.
To portray that story on the stage, though he is dancing alone.
Right. So it's like, again, you get a lot of improvisation. Can be done in Bharatanatyam, like Kathakali?
While doing choreography, not spontaneous improvisation.
Right.
While doing choreography.
Right. Okay, so Manish Gandhi, this is our last question because of today. Hello, Sarath. In Kathakali live performance, you do not have option of any retake. So how as a director you ensure that the performance go flawless? Or do you select a performer with certain parameters?
You know, because there is no question of once this that is a training for last 8 to 10 years. Within that, you get a basics of Kathakali, and almost people are assembling the musician, the dancer are assembling from different parts. But still, there are certain basic things are already being choreographed. And rest of the certain things has to be improvised by the artist. So it is definitely, it has to go and based on the artist's talent. So it goes flawless.
Right, Sharath, this is my last question. This is actually, I want to ask you, what are the good, what are the characteristics of a good Kathakali dancer? I mean, you might interview someone or you might want to talk with, you talk with a lot of people, a lot of dancers, but what are the characteristic of a good Kathakali dancer with a lot of depth and knowledge?
No, he must be very spiritual and he must be very highly devotionally disciplined and well disciplined, and which helps him to be away from kind of provocations and everything. And dreamer, that is the main thing. They think a lot and dream a lot, which probably comes as an improvisation on the stage.
Right, so you need a dreamer to be... That was a wonderful way of putting it. It was a pleasure having you, Sharath, with us today and sharing your knowledge.
Thank you so much for being with us today. I think I could do some justice to this.
No, it was wonderful. It was wonderful. We will, whenever we see a Kathakali dance performance next time, I'm sure we'll see it in a totally different light. Thanks to you. Thank you. Thanks to all of you.
Thanks to all of you.
And I hope the audience enjoyed as much as I did. Please fill in the poll before leaving. Give us your feedback. It helps us get better. And have a wonderful evening, everyone. Bye-bye. Take care and have a wonderful evening too, Sharad.